So my name is Chiara Ambrosio and I teach HPSC 0111, a course called Science, Art and Philosophy. So the course is a fantastic exploration into what scientists do when they produce images. And you see an example of this here next to me. The course takes place, in fact, in this very space, which is the UCL Art Museum. Many of the lectures will take place, in fact, in the Art Museum with actual artifacts. And we will explore what are the relationships between scientific practices and artistic practices with reference to real artworks. So we start in the course with a general philosophical thinking about the concept of representation. Representation is a very, very powerful concept in philosophy, and we explore how philosophers, at least since Plato, have been thinking about what it means to represent. And together with this kind of debates, we will see that there has been some kind of suspicion, especially since Plato's times, what is it that artists are doing when they are taking reality from out there and they are putting it on to a different medium. Both art and science are very much concerned with representing the world. But philosophers, since Plato again, disagree on what it means to represent the world. And so we will look a little bit at conceptual issues around representation, but then the second part of the course will become very, very practical. I've called it looking at representations in action. So we will actually study the practices of particular scientists, the relationship, for example, between mathematics and modernism at the beginning of the 20th century, the relationship between studies of time in physics and natural history and the visual arts. We will have quite a fascinating session on what photography did for scientists as well as for artists and so on. So it will be both a conceptual course if that is what you are interested in, but if you're interested in more practical issues in how both artists and scientists approach the topic of representation, there is something for you in that course as well. So the assessment is, I'm particularly proud about the assessment of this course. It's always really, really interesting to see what students come up with. So you will have to do the thinking once. You will have to settle on a project, a case of representation, a very particular artifact, something like this beautiful image, which has in fact a fantastic story. This is an image done by a medical practitioner called Charles Bell, surgeon and founder of the medical school at UCL, and there is a whole story of how Bell produced these images, a very interesting interplay between his identity as a surgeon interested in the body, in the nervous system in particular, and his other identity as an artist himself and as a medical practitioner who wanted to teach artists anatomy. So this is one of the possible case studies that you might want to pick up, and then you will be asked to write a written piece which will be in the style of an art and science journal. So you will imagine not just write an essay, but imagine what would it be like if this essay was to become an article submitted to a journal that deals with art and science. The same project will also be assessed through a poster. So if we study images, one of the most amazing skills you can get from this course is how to actually use images as part of an argument. And so I will ask you to do a poster on the same project on which you have written an article and use the visuals in a way that participates in the argument. And lastly, there will be a presentation. So you will stand in the UCL cloisters with a poster display with all your course mates. It's usually actually quite an important moment in our course when we have a poster display, because it's actually a way of seeing what everybody has done at once, and then we will do presentations on the poster, and you will do it standing in front of your poster in the UCL cloisters. So quite an exciting experience. Looks a bit daunting, but in fact the poster and the article and the presentation make for quite an interesting package that takes all the skills you might want to cultivate as part of this module. There are no prerequisites, so if you are interested in philosophy, that might help you with the first part of the course, but that is not a prerequisite. You just have to be willing to engage with debates that might not be necessarily in your immediate comfort zone. If you come from science and you haven't done a lot of philosophy, that's absolutely fine. You can capitalize, for example, on your scientific experience with images, and you can pick up a project for the assessment that actually helps you make the most of that experience. Similarly, if you come from an arts background, you can capitalize from your humanities, literature, history background, and engage with science from a humanities perspective. The course is also open to second year students. It might be a little bit of a challenge, because obviously it's a third year module, but nobody has ever failed to date, and second year students tend to do quite well. So if you're up for a challenge, this might be the course for you.